Former Prime Minister of St. Lucia, Michael Pilgrim, recalled that prior to the passing of Sir John Compton, he chose a new leader in the person of Stephenson King, who he felt was humble and sincere. He also described Mr. King as one who is not selfish, greedy, or corrupt. As a matter of fact, corruption was the main reason Mr. King gave for divorcing himself from the United Workers' Party. This as Mr. Pilgrim threw his support behind Mr. King as independent candidate for Castries North.
King was a former prime minister who deserved better treatment from his government. Why did he not walk away? Like any tolerant person in such a bad situation, he hoped that attitudes would have changed and that good sense would prevail. And eventually, his other cabinet colleagues would have intervened to preserve the dignity of a former prime minister. I too was disgusted with the treatment he received as a former prime minister, but I admired him for his patience, his tolerance, his cool, calm, and collected disposition, despite all the mental and psychological torture he endured. I must state very clearly and boldly that I'm in total support of his decision and would defend any action he has taken in this regard, for I sincerely believe that his action was selfless and in the best interests of the country.
Independent Senator Adrian Augier also supported Mr. King's decision. He sympathizes with Mr. King in his decision to part ways with the UWP, an organization which he served for 40 years. He says Mr. King deserves credit for making this life-saving decision.
Do we condemn him because his action defies our expectations and causes us discomfort? Or do we applaud his bravery and demand even more bravery of him?
It is left to be seen how Mr. King's decision will affect the UWP's chances at the polls, especially in Castries North. For the DBS News World, I'm Don Nicholas.